Now we're going to do some examples of series that you will find in the book. So first one is these a sequence or a series. So you do have some plus signs, but you realize that 2 plus 3 is 5, 4 plus 5 is 9, 6 plus 7 is 13. It's just a sequence of numbers. So that is a sequence. This one over here, that is an addition of numbers, you know, 2 plus negative 4 plus 6 plus negative 8. So that's definitely a series. It's not a geometric because negative 4 divided by 2 is negative 2, but 6 divided by negative 4 is not negative 2, so there is not a constant ratio, so not geometric. Other questions you'll see, deciding if a series is geometric or not. So you just do the ratio of successive terms. 3z over 3 comes out z. 6z squared over 3z comes out 2z. You already know you're in trouble there. And sure enough, 9z cubed over 6z squared, not working out. It's not a geometric series because there's no constant ratio. Now, if the front-running term is not, if that's messing up the constant ratio, you can peel that off and start the series from the moment where it does work and continue with working. And you can just add the front-running term to the result at the end. Finding this sum, we're going to do it by hand, and then we're going to check it with a couple of calculator methods. So first, we're just going to check that it really is geometric, so we can employ the formulas that we have for that. So 540 divided by negative 810 is negative 2/3. Negative 360 divided by 540 is negative 2/3, and if you check the rest, it is. So that part checks out. To employ the sum of the infinite series, we need the constant ratio to be less than 1, and the constant ratio is negative 2/3, so that in absolute value is indeed less than 1, so that checks out. So our A term is negative 810. Our constant ratio is negative 2/3. Plug it into the sum formula, comes out negative 486. Now we're going to verify that. We're going to verify that by figuring out the 18th sum. In other words, the sum of the first 18 terms, capital S sub 18. Why 18? It's a lot of terms, and by then we might see that the series is converging to negative 486. So I've written it in summation notation, the original series, and stopped it at the 18th term. So you can see that negative 2/3 is the constant ratio hitting on the negative 18, negative 810 each time. Why is there a k minus 1 here? Because since we're starting the summation with k equals 1, you can see that when k equals 1 and you put it in here, you'll have 0 up in the exponent. Negative 2/3 of 0 is 1, and you'll just get your first term, negative 810. When k increments to 2 on its way to 18, up here in the exponent, you'll have a 2 minus 1, which is a 1, and you'll hit the negative 810 with 1 power of negative 2/3, and that's how you get to your second term. And the summation says to add all those up from term 1 to 18, and so that's what we're going to get with our sum of our first 18 terms. And we have a formula for that, which is right here. That's a familiar formula for the sum of the first 18 terms, because we have 18 up there. And if you work that out, you get approximately this number here. And that certainly does look like it's verifying the infinite sum, even though we're only out to 18 terms. Now, you can also do this with calculator methods. The first method, just call it number 1. It's no better than number 2, it's just a different one. I'm going to put the partial sum formula into Y1 of the calculator. Now, there's going to be trouble with a graph if you try to graph it, because negative 2/3 to numbers like this, 9/2 and many other numbers that it will try to fill in, are not in the real number system. They're in the complex number system. They have that I thing going. So you're not going to graph it, because you're just going to get a blank graph with a couple of points here and there. What you're going to do is make a table. So you want to start at 1, k equals 1, or n equals 1. We had to put x up here. You know, so x equals 1. We're going to increment by 1s, because our counters are going by 1s. And then we generate our table. And these are the partial sums. So the sum of the first term is negative 810. The sum of the first 2 terms is negative 270. Sum of the first 3 terms is negative 630. The sum of the 18th term is negative 485.7. And that corresponds to what we calculated here. Okay, so that's one way to get partial sums and to approximate the infinite sum, because as you can see, these values here are approaching the negative 486. Okay, here's a calculator method number 2. I rewrote the original series here just so we see what, you know, that we have that. And just going over creating that general term inside the sum again. It was negative 2/3 hitting on the negative 810 each time and higher powers. So this was the term, the form of each of those numbers in the sum. And we're summing them up from 1 to 18 to get the sum of the first 18 terms. But that also can be written like this. And that's, as long as delta x is 1, your change is 1 that you're incrementing. That starts looking like an integral. So this sum approximates this integral right here. And if you use delta x equals 1 increments, you can numerically approximate that integral and get the sum that you want. So I'm going to give you a program called Riemann. I'll give you another one called Integral, but we can't use that because Integral has a method in it that it gives a solution for that uses all the x's. And again, we have that complex number problem because you're raising a negative number to a power. So Riemann just gives left and right sums, and there should be no problem as long as we're incrementing by delta x equals 1. So what you'll do is put that term here, and that's just each term, the expression for each term. You're going to put that into Y1 right here. Then you're going to click Program, select Riemann that I'm going to give you, enter. The lower boundary is 1. The upper boundary is 19, not 18. I'm going to show you why that is. The divisions the number of intervals is what that really means, is that formula B minus A over delta X, which is 19 minus 1 over 1, which is 18. So we want 18 steps, and we enter, and you get this number here. The left sum is what the one you want, which is exactly what we got before, because we had negative 485.7 for that sum of the first 18, and you can see that that's right on with the approximation, and that the actual series sum was negative 46. So why is this 19? What's that business going on? So since we're using a left sum, we have a left sum picture here. Now this is general, a general left sum picture. Just wanted to show you why you have to use 19. Since you're using a left sum picture, this area is the value for 1. This, the first term of the series is this area, because you're using delta x. So it's this height times delta x, which is 1. So this area stands for the first value of the series. This is the second value of the series. This is the third. This is the fourth. This is the 17th. You need to go beyond 18 because you're using a left sum. You need this right here to get the value for the 18th term. That's why you have to go to 19, because you're using a left sum. So that's the answer to that. Now, why I'm showing you this method is, one, you can check your answers that you have done by hand, but also, two, it's tying in a numerical approximation method to approximate an integral, in this case a definite integral, and we will be doing that later, so it's a nice tie-in to a subject later on in the course.